So today in this video, we will learn some really useful things about our front-end application bundle and how browser use caching for static files. I will take only 5 minutes to explain this, so watch this video till the end and like, comment and subscribe to my channel if you find this useful. So let's start. Whenever we complete our development, then we need to deploy our code on production server, right? At this point of time, we may have hundreds of files in our project which we have worked on, but we don't need to deploy those 100 files on server. Instead, we merge all JS and CSS files into one main JS and main CSS file, right? And deploy on those two files in our index.html on server. So now we will create a bundle for production. For this task, we have already have a script command npm run build. So we will try to create a bundle for this. First of all, let's create a bundle. So this command will create a build folder here in the root directory. So as you can see, this build folder is there. Okay, so this folder has everything related to our project. All files of public folder will be copied directly inside this build folder. So if you check build public, okay, let's minimize this. So if you check these files, favicon.io, these files will be directly copied in inside this build folder when you create a build. Okay, so and other thing, there is a static folder inside this build, and inside this static there is static CSS and static JS as well. So here you can see there are three files, 1, 2, and 3 JS file inside this JS folder. Okay, so but wait, why there are three files, not only one main JS file? Let me explain. This chunk file is this file is our vendor file basically. So this this file contains all the npm packages we have imported in our application. Okay, and this is our main JS file basically. So this file contains all our real code which we have written for our application. And this third file is webpack runtime file basically, which is used to start our application, right? But this this runtime code is directly embedded in our index.html to avoid any extra network call. So if I open this, so this code, this file is not used in index.html, but this code is copied directly. And if you see here index.html, so you can see this is the same code here. This code is for webpack runtime, this JS code. So this code is directly copied in index.html, and other two files like vendor.js, as you can see hash number here, 65 in the last and 65 here in the last. So this is our vendor.js file, and this is our main JS file, 510 in the last, and here 510 in the last. So this is our main JS file, and this is our vendor.js file. So these two files are added as a script file, and webpack runtime file is directly embedded in our index.html file, right? So basically we can see these three files are there inside our static JS folder. But if you use code splitting and dynamic module import, then the number of JS files may increase here also. But for this tutorial, we will not consider code splitting and dynamic import. We just use normal methods and without code splitting. But I have created a video on code splitting and dynamic import as well, so you can check that video also. Okay, but for now we will consider main JS file is our only single file for that. Okay, so now the question comes, why is there some weird number in the naming of these files, like this number and this number? So here comes the browser caching part basically. You all know that browser requests JS files when we load our application. But if nothing has changed in the application since the last request from the browser, so it's better that the browser should cache those files and don't request those files on every application load, right? But if something got changed in our application build, then how browser will get to know that it has to download a fresh version of JS file? So now we will use these weird numbers whenever anything change in our application and you make a build, then a new hash number is assigned to these files. So if you open this file like here, okay, so in the last of this file, this is source map URL. So this hash number is included in the file, in last of the file, end of the file, and the name of the file as well, right? Similarly for main file as well, like the same number here is also added in the last of this number, in the last of the file, right? Okay, so now we will use these weird numbers whenever anything change in our application and you make a build, then a new hash number is assigned to these files. So whenever you change anything and you create a build, then this number will be changed. But if you don't change anything in your code and you create a build again, then this number will remain the same, right? Okay, so when we load our application in browser, then browser compares its cached file hash number with the hash number of file on server. Like one copy of file is with the browser, okay, and browser can read this hash number from that cached file, and so browser compare that hash number with the hash number of file on server, and if it is different, okay, then it requests a fresh version of file. Otherwise, it will use a cached file. That's it. So let's try to demonstrate this. Before that, let's note down the number of these files first of all, so that we can compare easily. So if I compare, this is our main file. So if I say main JS file hash is here, okay, and if I say this is our vendor file basically. So vendor file number is here, and similarly runtime file. So no need for runtime because runtime is directly added, so no need for that. Okay, so let's try to make a build again. Okay, let me delete this build folder from here. Okay, let's make a build again. So I have not changed anything in code, so we are hoping that the same number will be assigned to those static files. Let's check again inside this JS, this one. Okay, so let me copy this number, and this is our main this file. So this is same number, as you can see, same hash number is generated for second build as well. Similarly, because we have not made any npm change, so npm import, so the same number will be there. As you can see, the same number is there, right? Okay, so now let's try to change something so that we can see hash number get changed. So if I say environment name, you can change anything, any small change will make this happen. Okay, let me save this, and then again I will delete this build folder. Okay, so now we will try to build again. Okay, so now as we have made change in our JS file, so this main JS file should get changed. This number should get changed. So if I compare this number with this main JS file number, so as you can see, now when we have made some change in our code, so the new hash number is assigned to our main JS file, right? So browser compare these numbers only to get the caching for static files, right? But if you see, this number is still the same because we have not made any change in our node modules. This is still same. Okay, so what browser do basically, browser mainly, like vendor file is not something which change regularly, vendor file or npm package which don't change regularly. So browser keep these files as a cached, but main file tend to change very quickly. So browser used these file as cache, but compare the number with the file hash on the server, right? So now you understand what these hash numbers are and how browser cache these static files. So if you find this video interesting and helpful, so please like, comment and share, subscribe to my channel. And if you have any thought related to this video or this strategy, so you can comment on this video as well. So for now, thank you so much.